I feel like David. I feel a little bit David. I feel like I could run through and get and leap over a wall. We used to do that song, Old Pentecostal Church. I would run through a loop and leap over a wall. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. I don't know about you, but God has done something in me, and I have a fire in me that is just wanting to jump out. And I thank God for what He's done in my life. What He has done, no man could have done. No amount of money could have done. No drug, no alcohol, nothing could have done what has been done to me. And I thank God for what He has done in my life. I thank God for what I'm seeing. I'm here to declare to you that there is a remnant.
Yes, they are.
There is a remnant
yes.
that is blood-bought.
Yes.
There is still a blood-bought church
yes.
that is doing right
yes.
and living holy.
Yes.
There is still a people
yes.
inside of people.
Amen.
You go to churches today, a lot of shouting,
yes.
but not a lot of substance.
Amen.
Not a lot of living holy.
Amen.
My father used to be one of those people. You go to church, pray, make the hairs on your arms stand up,
yes.
and go home and live like a devil. But there is an army rising up.
Come on, brother.
A mighty army that is rising up that the devil will not be able to stand in her way. She is the bride of Christ.
Yes.
She is the bride of Christ, and she's coming out from the wilderness,
yes.
and she's coming into her glory.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
But I want to read you a scripture. We've been visiting quite a few churches. And the pastor was speaking about how some people go through a near-life or near-death experience.
Uh-huh.
There are some churches that are near death.
Yes, they are.
And there are some that are just frankly dead.
That's right.
Come on. I'm trying to be honest with us today. I don't want to be dead. And I don't want to fool myself to believing that I am something that I am not. But we went to a church a few months back. We didn't know the people's life. We didn't know any of them. But there was a lady there that was possessed with the devil.
Uh-huh.
And let me tell you that you cannot counsel the devil out of people.
You have to be cast.
You can't counsel the devil out of people. You must be cast out. And I want you to know that we laid hands on that lady. And that was cast out of her. But I want to read you a scripture, and then I'll turn it over to Bishop. But this is my favorite scripture in the whole Bible. It says, "The earth is the Lord's, and the fullness thereof, the world, and they that dwell therein. For He hath founded it upon the seas, and established it upon the floods. Who shall ascend into the hill of the Lord?"
Mm-hmm.
Now we're talking about the character of God's people.
Yes.
Do they have character?
Yes.
They have standards. They have holiness in their life.
Yes.
Who shall ascend into the hill of the Lord? And who shall stand in His holy place?
Yes.
Come on now.
He that hath clean hands and a pure heart. That lets me know that you have to be clean on the inside and you got to be clean on the outside.
Right.
Clean hands.
Yes.
Pure heart.
Amen.
Come on now.
Who hath lifted up his soul unto vanity,
yes.
nor sworn deceitfully?
Yes.
Who shall receive the blessing from the Lord and righteousness from the God of his salvation?
Yes.
This is the generation of them that seek Him,
yes.
that seek
yes.
thy face, O Jacob, Selah. Like I said, there is a remnant. So lift up your head, O ye gates, and be ye lift up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in.
Yes.
Who is the King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty.
Come on now.
The Lord mighty in battle.
All right.
Yes,
yes there is a battle going on.
Yes, there are.
There are spirits that are raging,
yes.
but I believe if we could have our eyes opened up to the those that are for us, I believe there are more for us
yes.
than those that are against
now.
This church.
Amen.
We don't have to speak death and we don't have to speak weakness. We are strong.
That's right.
Not because of what we are, but because of what is in us.
Amen.
It says, lift up your heads, O ye gates, and be ye lift up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in.
Yes.
Who is the King of glory? The Lord, strong and mighty. The Lord, mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, O ye gates, even lift them up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in.
Amen.
Who is the King of glory? The Lord of hosts. He is the King of glory. And I wanted to just encourage you tonight that there is a remnant. There is an army. There is an army. And if you just hang on, keep running. Keep on running. No looking back, but keep on running. We're going to make it. You're going to be in that number. Because the saints are going to be marching. And we're going to be marching with power. And I am glad that I am one of them. I am glad today that I can say I am one of them. Church, I am glad that I am one of them. There is no question, there is no doubt. I am convinced, I am persuaded that I am one of them today.
And I turn this over to Bishop.
I thank God for that mighty army that is rising. He is rising.
Amen, that's good. Amen.
Amen. I've got just a few scriptures here.
Amen. And
driving across the mountain, amen, I began to think about these scriptures as they began to come to me by the revelation of the Holy Ghost. And
amen.
You know, we live in a time that it seems like that every one of us, we're in a battle.
Yes.
We're in a battle for our very lives. And it looks like the battle has increased. The fire has increased. Sickness has increased. It looks like that a lot of things has increased, but you know what? The anointing of God in our lives should also increase.
Oh, yeah.
I want to read you a scripture here in Psalms, the 62nd chapter, and I'll just preach for a brief minute here and leave you a word of encouragement.
Blessing,
truly my soul waits upon God.
Yeah.
From Him cometh my salvation. Ain't you glad that your salvation comes from Him, not nobody else? Hallelujah to Jesus. He only is my rock. Ha. Glory to God. And my salvation, He is my defense, and I shall not be greatly moved. Verse 6. He only is my rock and my salvation. He is my defense, and I shall not be moved. In God is my salvation and my glory and my rock and my strength and my refuge is in God. Trust in Him at all times, ye people, and pour out your hearts before Him. God is your refuge. You know, we live in a time, Brother Jesse, that the battles are great, but if we'll just pour out of ourselves to Him in praise, amen, the Bible says that He inhabits the praise of His people. And I come to that if we'll get in one mind and one accord, I'm here to tell you that we can see things begin to happen, amen. We can see sons and daughters born into the kingdom of God. We can begin to see, amen, healings take place. We can see deliverance take place. We are in an hour, amen, that we need to trust in God more than we trust in anybody else, because it's all in Him, friend. Amen. Sometimes we are tried by the fire. Oh, yes. When we go through the battles, amen, and we go through the trials, amen, He's there, amen, to help us, amen. I read in the scripture, amen, the three Hebrew men would not bow down to the idols of the world. They would not conform to the things of the world. And you know what? Praise God, they had to go into the fire. But you know what? The king went, and he looked down and he said, oh, did we not throw three? He said, behold, I see four. God is right there with you in the midst of the fire. Amen. And I'm going to tell you, glory to God, hell is going to heat up the battles with us so-called, amen, Christians and us true-born Christians, because it is His job, brother. The Bible said that He comes to steal and to kill and to destroy, and that is His mission, and He's on that job, Brother Jesse, to do exactly that. But we've got a God tonight, amen, that is our rock and our refuge. And it does. Brother Jesse, we can speak the word. Amen. And we can see the storms in our lives cease. Glory to God. I wonder tonight if God would come through the side door. If He would come through the back door. How many of us would be sitting down? Amen. Or how many of us would run up? Oh, that's my Jesus. Amen. But I've got news for us, Brother Mickey. He said, where two or three is gathered in my name. He said, I'm there in the midst. He's in this house. He will come on my Mahaya. He's in this house to do a work tonight. He's in this house to heal. He's in this house to deliver. And I've come to tell you tonight, He's in this house to save. Amen. I said, He's in this house to save. I feel Holy Ghost soul and power. And I'm here to tell you that if I can get one or two with me tonight, I'm here to tell you we can shake hell's foundation. I'm here to tell you the devil ain't going to give them to us, Brother Jesse. But the Bible said the kingdom of heaven suffers violence, and the violence takes it by force. Is there any soldiers in this house tonight? I said, any warriors in this house that'll serve notice on the devil? Amen. And tell the devil, this is a night somebody's coming home. This is a night somebody's going to be delivered. This is the night. This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. Hell sometimes will come our way, Brother Jesse. Glory to God. And we'll get some kind of bad news. Glory to God. And we'll get a news that we've got to go have a biopsy. It looks like there's cancer in our body. Glory to God. Or sometimes, amen, the devil will send bad news our way. Like he just did recently with my father. You've got 6 months to live. Glory to God, the cancer's ate up all of your body. And oh, how we'll begin to fear, amen. But I'm here to tell you tonight, I don't fear. Well, you know why? Because in Him is all things. He is my healer. He is my deliverer. He is my rock. He is my salvation. He's exactly what I need tonight. And it don't matter, glory to God, what the biopsy may say. Because the Bible said, glory to God, that He is able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all that I might think or I might ask. But you know what? The key to it is the name of Jesus. He said, whatever you ask in word or in deed, in the name of Jesus, it's going to be accomplished. Glory to God, I'm here to tell you that you can come out of the midst of the fire, out of the midst of the biopsy. You can come out of the midst of the mess that you're in. Your kids can come out of those drugs that they're on. Glory to God, that family that is suffering so great can come out. Glory to God, if you'll just begin to praise your way out. I see, Brother Jesse, praise is the key. Glory to God, I'm here to tell you that they were down in the jail cell. Sissy, they had their back beat. But you know what the Bible said about midnight? They began to sing praises unto God. And suddenly the Bible said there was an earthquake. I said suddenly. Is there anybody here that understands we're in a suddenly hour? We're in the midnight hour. And I've come to tell the devil, move on over. Glory to God, there's going to be some shaking. There's going to be some things. Glory to God, begin to fall off because of praise. See, I've been through Hurricane 1, Hurricane 2, and 3, and 4, and 5, and I came out as a survivor, Brother Mickey. The real test is not how loud you can shout. The real test is when you go through the fire, and you can come out and you still have a thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Praise you, Jesus. Glory to God. That's the real test. And when you go through the fire. Glory to God, you don't lose your praise. You got your praise when you come out. Glory to God. Is there anybody in here that has a praise? Glory to God, if you'll get your praise on, I hear the Holy Ghost saying, I'll shift the storm for you. I hear the Holy Ghost saying that if you'll praise me, glory to God, I'll take care of it. Amen. I hear God saying that if you'll lift me up, I'll draw all men unto me. Glory to God. We want somebody saved tonight. We've got to lift him up. We've got to praise him, because the greater we lift him up, the more power's coming in and the more drawing power. Glory to God. There is no match for the devil. How many's willing to praise him? He is my rock. He is my salvation and my defense. I don't know about anybody else, but glory to God, most of my life it's just been me. Glory to God, because I've not trusted in a lot of people. Because you know, in this day and time, they shake your hand. Glory to God, with the others, they're stabbing you in the back, Brother Mickey. Come on. But I know a man by the name of Jesus, Brother Jesse, that said, I'll go all the way, even to the end of the world. He said, amen, that he's a brother that sticketh, that he's a friend that sticketh closer than any brother. And I'm so glad that he's my rock tonight. Amen. I'm glad that he's my salvation. They asked a question one time. They said, glory to God, who does man say that I am? Jesus asked them, said, who does man say that I am? He said, some say Elijah, some say Jeremiah, some says this and some says that. But Jesus looked at him and said, Peter, who do you say that I am? He knew who he was. He said, thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. But you know what? I believe God's asking you the very question tonight. Who do you say that he is? Glory to God. What is he in your life tonight? Is he your salvation? Is he your healer? Is he your deliverer? Amen. Is he your rock? I'm here to tell you, Peter knew who he was. And he told him, he said, Peter, blessed are thou, for flesh and blood is not revealed this unto you. Glory to God, but my Father which art in heaven. And he said, upon this rock will I build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail. I'm here to tell you, church, that if you're in him, you're hell proof. The devil can do nothing for you. You know why? Because when you are in God, he is no match for him. And I'm going to close just with this. He said, oh God, thou art my God, early in the morning will I seek thee. My soul thirsts after thee, my flesh longeth after thee. In a dry and thirsty land where there is no water, to see thy power and thy glory. Is there anybody in this place that is hungry to see the power of God, to see the glory of God? Come on. I said, is there anybody in this house that is really thirsty and really hungry to see the power of God poured out into the church tonight? I'm here to tell you, that's what we're lacking in the hour that we live. That's why souls ain't being born into the kingdom of God. Because we can't come together in one mind and one accord. Amen. Begin to praise the name that's above every name in the church world today. It's a look at me. Glory to God. Look at my ministry. I'm here to tell you, you better get your eyes off of your ministry and get them up on Jesus. He said, if I'll be lifted up, I will draw all men unto me. I'm here to tell you, pride will go before a fall. And there's many that has went down the road. I'm looking for somebody that's a nobody that's willing to praise the name of the Lord. Glory to God. Is there anybody in this house that is wanting to see his power and his glory? So as I have seen thee in thy sanctuary. I think about the times that I pastored just in Ravencliff. 6-8 years ago, the power of God that was poured out there, Brother Jesse. Yes. We went to 8 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, going strong. We would take and we would baptize anywhere between 20 and 30 in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sin. Come on. I'm here to tell you there was times that we got done with the baptism around 12:01. Go in and they began to pray for the Holy Ghost. And we were there till 7 o'clock. Glory to God. And they would go down and cook breakfast and then we would go home. Glory to God, because they were hungering for the power of God. The Bible said, blessed are they that thirst and hungers after righteousness, for they shall be filled. How many hungry people do we have in the house of God? I come to tell somebody, you're looking for the answer. The answer ain't in the drugs. The answer ain't in sex. The answer ain't everywhere else. But it is in Jesus Christ. He's your answer tonight. He's your salvation. And he said, behold, I stand at the door and I knock. If any man hear my voice and open up the door, he said, I'll come in and I'll sit with him and him with me. Because of thy love and kindness, it is better my lips praise thee. How many lips is going to praise thee tonight? Thus I will bless thee while I live, and I will lift up my hands in thy name. And my soul shall be satisfied as the marrow, and the fatness of my mouth shall praise thee with joyful lips. Glory to God. And I shall remember thee upon my bed, and I shall meditate upon thee as the night watches. I've come to tell somebody tonight, glory to God, that he's all that you need. I don't care, glory to God, what you're going through. Glory to God, I don't care who's betrayed you. I don't care what kind of sickness is in your body. Glory to God, I don't care what kind of drugs, glory to God, your son or your daughter may be on. I don't care what kind of addiction they're in. I've come to tell you the name of the Lord Jesus is greater than any of that. And all you got to do is get in a place with God tonight and lift up holy hands without wrath and without doubt. And I'm telling you, call those things that ain't as if they are, because they're coming out. Why? They've been promised to you. Amen. I'm here to tell you the Bible said that if I believe upon the Lord, amen, my household shall be saved. They're mine. Amen. Glory to God. They're a promise from God. And I've come to tell the devil, he's got to back off. Amen. There's a remnant coming up. That's not afraid of the devil. They're not afraid of the schemes and the wiles of the devil. Why? Shall harm us. He said that I'll give you power to lay hands upon the sick. Come on. How many believers do we have in the house? If we've got believers in the house, we ought to shake hands foundation tonight. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but I deliver them out of them all. I'm here to tell you tonight there's a shifting. I said there's a shifting. I hear it, Brother Jesse, a shifting in the storm for all of those that are willing to praise the name of the Lord. I'm here to tell you, I don't care what you're going through tonight, there is a shifting in the storm. I feel it in the Holy Ghost. Brother, I'm here to tell you that I don't care what you're going through. Glory to God, there is a shifting in the realm of the Spirit for those that are willing to praise Him. Now, come on. Glory to God. I'm here to tell you that I don't care what the devil says. There's healing in that house. By the blood He covered. In the name of Jesus, all we got to do is lift him up. I'm not worried about who's here tonight. Amen. Because I know he's in the house. And he makes the difference to that church. And him. You began to glorify his name. I'm here to tell you, glory to God, God's going to open up heaven. And I hear the Holy Ghost saying, I'm going to begin to move. Glory to God. Who's able to stop him? The Bible said, brother, when he begins to move, glory to God, there's nobody able to stop the move of God. How many people's in the house tonight that's willing to praise him? How many's got a storm going through their life? How many's got a storm? Before we get our next preacher up, I'm going to ask that we just sing one song. Brother Andy, will you come and lead us in this? And I'm done, and we'll call the next preacher. I want you to come and lead us in that song that we sing all the time, the battlefield going into the other one.
And as he sings this, I want us just to take a moment and praise him. If we will, just praise him. I want you to pray for those that are in this house tonight that is lost. Because I'm here to tell you, I feel the Holy Ghost about to do something.
Amen.
He said that if I be lifted up, he said, I'll go home in. Yea, I say I will go home in. Yea, I'm in this house to move, saith God. Oh, we are praising tonight as he sings. And then we'll get the next preacher. But I feel a shifting, sister. Glory to God, Becky. I feel a shifting in the house of God tonight. I feel, Brother Jesse, God wants to do something in this house. Would you just begin to praise him for a moment? If everybody will, we would just stand. Everybody that will, we just stand and begin to praise him. Come on, let's pour our heart out to him. I feel the Holy Ghost. Brother Jesse, come on, will you praise him? Come on, glory to God. Oh, if this was your child, wouldn't you be praising God with everything in you? Oh, come on, will you praise him? Glory to God, lift him up. Lift him up, lift him up. Glory to God.
Oh yes, I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. Oh yes, I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. I promised him that I would serve him till I die. Now I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. I'm fighting for my Savior. The battle is most won. The trumpet will be sounding. The coming of the sun. I'll lay my armor down. Take off my robe and crown. Then I'll walk the golden street with my Lord. Oh yes, I'm on the battlefield for my Lord.
Yes,
I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. I promise him that Jesus.
keeping me alive.
Yeah,
he's all over me, and he's keeping me alive. Keeping me alive. Keeping me alive. Well, he's all over me, and he's keeping me alive. I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. Yes, I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. I promised him that I would serve him till I die. Now I'm on the battlefield for my Lord.
Praise the Lord. If you didn't feel that something in the house tonight, you need to come to the altar, because the Holy Ghost is here and is moving tonight. You know, the brothers were talking about him, but you know what? The Lord brought it to me. He said, Proverbs 18:21, life and death in the power of the tongue. Hallelujah. You know what? If you speak the word, it will perform tonight. But you know what? I'm going to tell you something. Don't let fear bother you tonight, because God didn't give you the spirit of fear, but to give you a power of love and a sound mind tonight. I'm going to tell you tonight, you need to be led by the Holy Ghost. You need to let God have His way tonight. You want something from God, you need to be praising Him tonight, like the brother said. Hallelujah, you need to raise your hand. Honey, let me tell you something. If it wasn't, He didn't have to do it, but He did. He didn't have to die on that cross and shed His blood for you, but He did. He woke you up this morning, and He placed you in this church house tonight. You're not here by no accident. You're not here in this house of the Lord tonight. This is an ordained thing here tonight. God ordained this tonight. Honey, everybody can receive tonight if you will believe. Let me tell you, if Brother Clyde had a big table of food at his house tonight and you went, did you know what you had to do? You ain't going to just sit in that living room floor there in that couch. You're going to get up when it says come and eat. That's like Jesus is saying, come and dine tonight. He said, come and get it tonight. I got it here for you. The table is spread. Come and eat tonight. Do you know that He that's in us is greater than he that's in the world? God has given us power over the enemy tonight. We need to bind up the devil. You know what? We need to take a stand and say, devil, you can't have that soul tonight. We claim them in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah tonight. We claim them and we plead the blood of Jesus over this place here tonight. Hallelujah. Because you know what? He's in the house tonight. Hallelujah. You know what? The thief comes to steal, kill, destroy. But Jesus come that you can have life and you can have it more abundantly. I don't know who you are, but let me tell you something. Take this whole world to give me Jesus. This whole world ain't got nothing for you tonight. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But you with God, you have peace. Jesus is peace tonight. And without Him, you ain't got no peace tonight. We ain't nothing. But He said, I can do all things through Christ which strengthens me in Philippians tonight. And we know what you can do things through Christ which strengthens us tonight. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We need to be led by the Holy Ghost. You need to praise Him tonight. Give Him praise. Don't look at Sister Becky. Don't look at the brothers that are here tonight. Look at Him tonight. Give Him praise tonight because He's worthy. Hallelujah. We got shoes on our feet. We got clothes everywhere. We got food to eat. You need to thank Him tonight. You need to praise Him that you got breath in your body. You need to praise Him tonight because He's worthy to be praised tonight. Hallelujah. Do you know what? Like the brother said, let me tell you something. You know what? Those in the wilderness that could have came out, but they complain. That's our trouble tonight. We complain too much. Hallelujah. When we should praise Him. Because you know what? If we praise Him, we'll get out of our problems quicker and faster tonight.
Come on, man.
Hallelujah. You know what? The Apostle Paul said, when I went to do good, evil was always present. He's not only talking about some devil. He's talking about your flesh tonight. Let God take over tonight. Let God take over tonight. begin to praise the Lord and say, you don't feel like it. If you don't feel like it, do it anyhow. You say, oh, I can't praise, but you can praise. Because you know what? If you begin to praise Him tonight and God sees you by faith praising Him, you reaching out and touching Him, God can move for you tonight. Amen. It's up to you what you want from God tonight. Ask yourself, what do I want from God tonight? Is there anything standing in between me and God tonight? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Is there anything in our lives that we need to be moved out of our way tonight? Because you know what? It's sad when you come into the church and we don't see a hand raised tonight. Do you know that when you raise your hands and praise the Lord that you're yielding to the Spirit of God? Does people realize that we're making this flesh come under subjection, that we're yielding to the Spirit of the Lord tonight? Hallelujah. Like the brother said, if those three Hebrew children, you know, when they went into the furnace of fire, they had faith because you know what? The fourth man was there. They didn't bow down. I'm going to tell you something tonight. Let's don't bow down to whatever it is. God is a jealous God. He said, I'll have no other gods before me. You know, it's appointed unto man to die and after the judgment. We don't know that we might walk out that door. We don't know that we might sit here and just fall over just like this. Because we don't know, but only God knows. But with God, all things are possible. With man, it's not. I'm going to tell you something. I've been in the world, but God, He brought me out of that world. I've had those things of the world. I worked at jobs and had big money and had fine cars, but let me tell you something. I went down to the bottom. But you know what? I came up because God reached down His hand and He pulled me up. And you know what? These material things is going to pass away, but God's word will never pass away. Jesus said, I will never leave you. I'll never forsake you, and I'll go with you all the way. I know what it's like to feel peer pressure out there. I know what it's like when people expect you to do things and you're doing, trying to make people happy, but it's time to make God happy. It's time to do what God said to do. You know what? The devil really don't like you. The devil don't really care for you. All he wants to do is destroy you, because a thief coming to steal, kill, and destroy. But Jesus coming, we can have life. The devil just lying to you tonight. The devil just saying, oh, I'll give you this. I'll give you that. That's what he tried on Jesus. But honey, it didn't work. Hallelujah. Because you know what? Jesus was our example. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Jesus didn't bow down. Hallelujah. And I'm going to tell you what, we know the end, because you know what? God is still showing him that he's boss. God is boss. Hallelujah. And the devil's in. He's going to be in that lake of fire. Hallelujah. Praise God. And you don't want nobody, we don't want nobody to go to that lake of fire where the worm will never die. And that fire is, it's going to be a fire that's unquenchable, that's going to just keep on burning. But I'm going to tell you something. In this last day, I believe that God is raising up a people that's going to be able to, going to walk. I believe you're going to be like Peter when you walk by people, that the glory of God is going to be so strong from you, that anointing out of the bellies will flow in rivers of living water. When you walk by, they're going to feel the power of the God. They're going to get saved. They're going to get healed, brother. They're going to get delivered. Amen. Amen. Because you know what? God is going to show, we'll do it one more time again. God is going to reveal His glory in His people, and it's going to shine. You can look at the gloom and doom all you want to, but you got to start looking at the good. You got to stop looking at what God's got for you and what's coming and what is ahead. Hallelujah. Too many people saying, you know what? I've been there for a little while. Yes, I have. I'm talking about Sister Becca right now. I've been there here lately in a storm. I'm telling you, it was a rough storm. Oh, the devil said, I'm not going to make it. But God in me said, I'm going to make it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He said, he that's in me is greater than he that's in the world. He that's in you is greater than he that's in the world. He that's in us tonight is greater than he that's in the world. Hallelujah. Do you know what? We limit God too much. That's our problem. We limit God too much. Hallelujah. We do. It's a small thing to God. Oh, God, it's big enough that it holds this earth and this whole world in his hand. But yet he's small enough to live within our man hearts, a man, woman, and child. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There is a great revival and it's coming. It's coming. The latter and the former. But this latter is going to be greater than the former. Hallelujah. Because you know what? A lot of people's getting weary and tired and well-doing. But I'm going to tell you, this ain't no time to get weary. It ain't no time to get tired. It ain't no time to sit down. It ain't no time. Yes, it ain't no time, because I'm going to tell you something. God is going to move in a mighty way. I want to be in that move to God tonight. How many wants to be in the move of God tonight? Raise your hand and say, Lord, I want to be in that move. God, I want to be in this life-saving revival. Lord, more than anything, I want to make it. More than anything, I want to make it. Because this whole world ain't got nothing for me. Oh, you can have your diamond rings. You can have all your money. You can have all these fancy-looking things they want. But I'm going to tell you, they're material things. And they're going to go away. They're going to burn in that fire. Hallelujah. But you know what? I'm going to walk on the streets of gold. I'm going to see Jesus, the one who died for me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And we're going to see loved ones that's gone home before us. But I'm going to tell you why a lot of people say, well, I'm going to get blessed when I get over there. But Brother Jesse, I believe we're going to be blessed before we get over there. Hallelujah. I believe we're going to be blessed. If I'm like you, brother, I believe just like you do. I believe the blessing is coming. Hallelujah. And there ain't no devil out of hell going to stop what God's getting ready to do. So the devil is a liar and a father of a lie tonight. The devil is lying to people and saying, hey, I can give you better, but he can't give you better. Because ain't nobody can do you like Jesus. Ain't nobody can bless you. Ain't nobody can love you like him tonight. Hallelujah. Come on, Sister Betty, say something for the Lord. Well, praise the Lord. How about Sister Jane here? I know she's always ready.
Well, the Bible says, be therefore always ready, for the Son of Man comes in an hour when you think not. That's when he comes. I didn't come to preach tonight. I told her on her way. I said, I'm going to listen to you. I'm going to hear everybody else. But I want you to know tonight that I'm on the battlefield, brother. I promise him that I'd serve him till I die. That's what we promised him, every one of us, when we went down to that altar. Every one of us said, Lord, we'll go with you all the way. But how many of us kept that promise? How many times did we fall short of keeping what we're supposed to do? How many times have we had to go back and say, God, forgive me. Carry me one more time. Send me one more blessing, Lord. Lift me up. I fell to you and I'm falling short of what I should have been. But God, I know you'll still hear me if I call to you. He's coming back after a church that's made themselves ready. I come tonight expecting to see a move of God. And I keep hearing a voice in my ear saying, prophesy. And I say, what shall I prophesy? And he says, say that all flesh is grass. And it is today, and tomorrow is cast into the oven. Hallelujah, you're a short time and full of trouble. Man that is born of good, woman is few days and full of trouble, even as the sparks fly upward. Man, you ever watch how much the sparks fly off a bonfire when you build one? Yeah. Them little sparks go up real fast and they're out like that. Yeah. But we don't want to be like the sparks that go out. We want to be the ones that continually burn. Keep that continual burning in our heart for him. Troubles is going to come. As long as we in this flesh, they're going to be trouble. But when we get out of this flesh and we can get over into the spiritual realm, honey, we'll feel my that we are the redeemed.
Amen.
Oh, I'm the redeemed of the Lord, and let the redeemed of the Lord say so. I'm going to stand up and say, I've been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. Saved and sanctified I am. Honey, it wasn't through nothing that I done or could do, but it's through and by the blood of Jesus Christ that I'm saved and sanctified today. My God, if I told you some of the things He brought me through, you'd say, you're joshing me. Nah, surely that didn't happen to you. Let me tell you something, honey. When you first get saved and you start walking with Jesus, everything in the book's going to hit you. Everything along life's way is going to stomp you and kick you. And you're going to have every kind of trouble there is. When you go down to that altar, rise up prepared to fight, because you just joined an army. You got to put your armor on because you've got some fighting to do if you're going to be a child of God. You've got to resist the devil, but you can't resist him without first submitting yourself unto God. Everybody likes to say that. Resist the devil and he'll flee from you. They don't like to say the part that comes in front says, submit thyself therefore unto the Lord, and then resist the devil and he'll flee from you. You've got to first be submitted unto God before the devil will flee from you.
Amen.
You want to get rid of the devil? Submit yourself to God.
Amen.
Look to him and watch the devil flee.
Amen.
You don't just say Jesus, Jesus, Jesus till you turn blue in the face and get rid of the devil. Why, he'll stand there and laugh at you. And let me tell you, when he's got a hold of somebody and got his claws in him, don't think he's just going to turn them loose and get out of there, devil. No, sir, buddy, you want to do some fasting, you're going to do some praying, and you're going to do some fighting with that devil to get it out, because it don't want to come out.
Right.
It likes being there.
Right.
It's got a host, and it's going to suck it dry, and it's going to take all the life out of it if it's not gotten out of it. And, honey, you don't get it out just by talking nice to it. You can't talk nice to the devil. You can't say, come on, devil, come out, because he ain't going to listen to us that way. You got to tell him like it is. You got to say, I got the power over you, and there's power in the name of Jesus, and we've been endued with power from on high, and at the name of Jesus, you've got to go. Might not come the first time you tell him. Let me tell you, sometimes it's a real battle getting them out. Sometimes they just don't want to come out at all. They'd just rather stay there, and the person that's got them thinks they're of God, so therefore they don't want to turn loose of them. They can want to keep it because they think, hey, they're trying to tell me to let go of God, and not realizing this thing ain't of God. They don't want to turn it loose.
Come on.
Oh, I've been there and done that.
Yep.
I've been there when you have to get up at 2 o'clock in the morning and rebuke devils that open your doors and windows and command him to go.
Yes, amen.
Because he's trying to kill a member of your family.
Amen.
And he don't care. He don't care how old you are or how young you are. He don't care what race you are. He don't care if you're rich or poor. He don't care. He's out to kill and to steal and destroy. And he's out to steal your soul. He's out to take your joy. He's out to take your peace. He's out to take the things that Jesus come to give you. But he can't take them. He can lie. He can sit on your shoulder. He can whisper in your ear. But that's all he can do. Because you got your armor on, he can't get through the shield. It says, take him therefore the shield of faith, whereby ye shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the enemy. We're going to quench them all. And brother, I wonder what happened to you in your mid-20s. Something traumatic. Something very traumatic. Would you like to tell us about it? Not tonight.
You ain't got time.
We ain't got time for that, but it happened. You don't know me.
Yeah, I
do. You did? Where did I meet you?
You met me here. You met me in McDowell County.
Yes, I've met you before.
Right here.
Right here. Right here in this church.
Here in this church and then the little...
Oh, I'd like to hear your testimony. I think he'd do something for you.
Yeah.
But bless God, he'll tell it again sometime. I'll hear him again. But I didn't remember you. I'm sorry. But I did see you this week. You didn't see me. I know you didn't see me, but I saw you. And I said, why am I seeing him? And tonight I come here, There's a reason for it. God never shows us something there's not a reason behind. And lots of times, I feel like that sometimes just a little handful of purpose will go a whole lot further than any other thing. Because when God proposed a plan of salvation, it didn't happen instantly. It was planned. It come down the road. It took it 30 years to come to fruition, to come and go to that cross. And then it was still 3 years of preaching before that he went to that cross. But I'm tired of hearing him left on the cross. Jesus come off of the cross. He came down from the cross. Amen. He is no longer on the cross. And he won't go back to the cross anymore. These preachers that want to leave him on the cross need to take him off the cross and let him be the God of glory that he is, because he came off the cross. He came out of the grave and he is ascended into the heavens, sitting on the right hand of power, and now he's making intercession for us.
Amen.
For the things that go wrong in our life, for the times that we fail. And in this miserable life that we live, there's joy that surpasses understanding. There's peace that goes beyond understanding.
Amen.
Through every trial and every storm, I've seen blessing after blessing after blessing. And I have people say to me, your life is a horror story, so I'll not bother y'all with it. Your life is a horror story. How can you walk in peace with all this going on? And the only thing I can say is I am the redeemed of the Lord. And I've been blood bought. And honey, I've been filled from heaven with the Holy Spirit. And he's going to walk with me and take me through every trial. And when I get through, there's something better on the other side. Oh, there's milk and honey on the other side. There's the most beautiful mansion. My name's on the door.
Yeah.
Never been there yet, but I'm going there. Someone else take my ticket. Someone else take my prize. Someone else made my way that I didn't have to go through these things. Someone else named Jesus done it all. And the only thing we got to do is believe in our heart and confess with our mouth that Christ died for our salvation, that he was born of the Virgin Mary, that he rose again the third day, leaving his vicarious death on the cross, and confess it with our mouth and believe in our heart, and we shall be saved. God bless you all.
God, give me something. There's somebody here tonight. The Lord kept bringing it to me. I'm going to obey God tonight. Just right here. Praise the Lord.
There's somebody here tonight. I don't know who you are, but God knows who you are tonight. Goes along with something that the brother come out and said. And so Isaiah 41 and 10. Fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee. Yea, I will help thee. Yea, I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness. There's somebody here. You've been going through something there tonight. And then it says there in 14 said, fear not. I mean 13 said, for I, the Lord thy God, will hold thy right hand, saying unto thee, fear not, I will help thee. There's somebody here tonight, you're going through something here tonight. And you've had fear that's battled you over it. And you're worried. You've had doubts, you've had fears, and they've been battling you. The brother says, brought out about how what God can do for you tonight. The brother here brought out about doubt. The brother here has brought out about fear in different times here. As somebody here tonight, you need to not be dismayed. You need to know that God didn't give you that spirit of fear, but a power of love and a sound mind. You've been a Holy Ghost filled. You're, sis, come here. You. Come here, you. Yes. You've been praying about some things, and you've been going through some battles, but God said for you not to be dismayed and not be fear, because there's doubt been fighting you at times, and the devil has fed you. But you know what? He that's in you is greater than he that's in the world. And brother Kleins and this brother here and these brothers, people come and pray for her tonight and pray. Hallelujah, because she's been through a battle. Hallelujah, but God's going to give her strength.
But now thus saith the Lord, I have created thee, O Jacob, and I have formed thee, O Israel. Fear not, for I have redeemed thee, and I have called thee by name, and thou art mine. And when thou pass through the waters, I shall be with thee. And though the rivers, they shall not overflow thee. And when thou walkest through the fire, thou shalt not be burned. And neither shall the flame kindle upon thee, for I am the Lord thy God.
See us right there beside that, you right there. God's showing me right now to you too. You need prayer too tonight. You need prayer.
Lord, right now, in the name you've been, of
what,
God,
prayer
we are
for
our sister battle? Tonight, God. Yeah. Lord, believe in thy word, O God. Lord, we know, God, that thou art able, O God, to do exceedingly and abundantly above all that we might think or we might ask. Lord, we come together in the unity of the
Lord,
Spirit, God,
you've been going
and we
through
lift
the
up God, and we speak
you've
to the devil right now in the name of Jesus, that he's got to go from
your
mind.
They're going to pray for you, and I want you to release that power, okay? I want you to release that and give it to
God,
because that depression is battled your mind. You've had nine battles going on, and you've even been told you're nothing, but honey, you are something. You are somebody in Jesus tonight. You hear me? You hear me tonight? Hallelujah. 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 I want you to pray for me tonight. And she's battled with that. She feels like she's nobody, but she's somebody in the Lord. Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus.
Yes, praise the Lord.
I come against the spirit of depression.
Yes, amen.
Right now, in the name that's above every name. Oh, in the name where there's healing.
Jesus, hallelujah.
In the name where there's deliverance.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise you, Jesus. Yandere, sondere, yakuma, mataya.
In the name of Jesus, God, right now I ask that you would move by
Jesus,
your Spirit, God.
Yes, the Lord showed me you need strength. Those times that you get weak, you need strength.
Oh,
I'm going to pray for you. I'm going to pray for you. You need strength in your body.
Yes, say, give him to me,
yeah, honey,
God.
The Lord loves you.
Yeah,
tonight.
Give him unto me. Yeah, okay. I'm able to move, saith
yes,
God.
Yes, Lord.
Yeah, I know the intent of thy heart. And yeah, I see
Jesus.
The need of thy tears. And
Jesus.
Yeah, I say,
yes, and you pray a lot, sissy.
Yeah,
the Lord says that you've been praying for some to get saved. Amen. Amen. We're going to pray. God's going to give you strength tonight. And you've been praying that there's one to get saved. Hallelujah. Amen. But she needs strength in her body tonight. The Lord showed me she needed some strength.
I rebuke every spirit of doubt. I rebuke every spirit, God, of depression. I rebuke every spirit that would come to tell her that she is nothing or no one. Oh, Lord, for you have made us somebody. And you said, let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Oh, she's covered by the blood, devil, in the name of Jesus. The blood has made her worthy. The blood made her whole tonight.
Yes, Lord. This sissy right here, I want you to pray that God will give her strength in her body. She needs strength. She's fought a long, hard battle, but she needs God to give her strength in her body and heal her.
Lord, right now we anoint according to James chapter 5, God. Lord, you said if there be any sick among them, let them call for the elders of the church and let them anoint them in oil and pray the prayer of faith. Oh, right now, God, I speak to this vessel, God, strength, God, I speak to it, healing. You said where two or three is gathered in your name, that you're there in the midst, and whatever we ask in faith, believing, we shall receive. Right now, in the name of Jesus, I release healing, God, into this vessel. God,